Humans have always had a fascination, the mysterious and the unexplained. Some say we get a thrill out of facing fear. Well, tonight, we will show you a conspiracy so shocking that it just might scare your socks off. We're standing outside the University of Western Sydney, Nepean. Like many universities across the globe, it tests its students by giving them essays. And, like many universities across the globe, it has become the site of a strange and unexplained phenomenon, essay abduction. Students at this university work hard for their marks. It's a known fact. They also hand in their essays, also a known fact. However, what is not always known is what happens to these essays after they're handed in.
Yeah, I don't usually do badly in essays. Mostly credits, but sometimes a distinction or two. But I suppose if I'm passing, that's the main thing.
I've lost essays lots of times too, actually. Like at the end of semesters and stuff, hey.
We've never seen our assignments. No one ever got their assignments back, and no one knows how or why we all got a credit, why no one failed, or why no one, you know, did better than a credit.
Some tutors and lecturers at this university don't know how they got their jobs sometimes.
No.
God.
How could it be that in a modern university, such as the University of Western Sydney, could students not get their assignments returned? A simple admin error? Lazy lecturers or tutors? Or perhaps something darker?
It was late 1994, so I was relatively new to the university. I had a lot of faith in the uni system because my lecturers were always really good. Anyway, one day this man in a black suit came up to me and said he was from some kind of government organisation that had to study student essays. Something to do with Ausstudy or uni fees or something. Anyway, he was really quite pleasant until I told him that I couldn't give him the student essays without their express permission. At that point he became hostile and started ranting and raving. 2 days later I went into my office and about 15 essays were missing from my desk.
At this university, the rate of lost and missing essays has nearly tripled. And this trend has seemingly continued on university campuses in this country and across the globe. What's causing this? Well, evidence for this mystery may lie in the testimonies of lecturers.
I was teaching at this very high-profile college in the States, and actually it was quite a terrifying incident. I can only talk about it now, but I was marking essays at my desk, and there was a knock at the door, and I answered the knock, and this guy came in. He seemed all right, like a pleasant disposition, although he was wearing this very dark suit and dark glasses, which was kind of odd, and he said, you know, what are you doing? And I said, I'm marking some essays, so I don't really have time to chat right now. And he said, no, you're not. And he put a gun to my head, and I was like, oh my goodness, what's going on? And he said, give me all the essays that you have in this room, you know, that I was checking here. And he took all my essays, and he said, if I ever repeated this story to anyone else, that I would pay the consequences. So it was just a terrifying incident.
During the research for this documentary, many more lecturers and certain anonymous parties approached us with startling evidence of a conspiracy to rob students of their essays. Understandably, many of them were too afraid to appear in this film. But for what reason and for what purpose are essays being stolen? And for that matter, why would the world's governments jeopardise the future of the world's academics?
The history of this phenomenon begins at least as far back as ancient Rome, when certain Roman imperial essays on the pantheistic validation of making the imperial pets official senators vanished among great scandal. Across the span of the centuries, writing of a scholarly nature disappeared under mysterious circumstances. But it is only within this half of the 20th century that these essay abductions, as it were, have been so prevalent.
So I go up to Janice and I say, where's my feature article? And she says, Don't have it. Not here.
It doesn't mean nothing, man.
I'm offended. I'm astounded. I'm shocked. I say, what do you mean you don't have it?
Like, you hand them in, and then if you don't come on the day to get them again, they're gone. And that's it.
There's an essay gremlin somewhere in the university.
Do you think?
I think they slipped through eddies in the space-time vortex. Are you buying that?
Until recently, these stories were considered ridiculous. Yet another thing for students to complain about. But with this new evidence that has come to light, how can the new possibility be ignored? Roswell 1947. Alien spacecraft crashes in the desert near Roswell. Here, military personnel are shown posing with artifacts which include what appear to be a student essay. In 1992, this site of an alleged alien landing left behind a curious item. A scorched but still recognisable UWS folder containing a student essay.
They just took them! I had no control! I mean, they were coming in and taking all of the essays. I had to hide them in my office so they wouldn't take them. They even took part of my thesis on the social and intellectual evolution of mankind.
Various governments around the world have denied all knowledge of any such activities, either authorised by them or not. Are the world's governments conspiring with extraterrestrials to steal student essays? Dr. Copeland, formerly of SETI, believes so.
The government has been stealing essays since 1953. Essays found on the Roswell craft were also abducted by aliens, and they've been in contact with us ever since, especially the world powers. There's been an intergalactic pact made whereby we steal essays on their behalf, and they provide us with higher technology. Much is still under wraps. It's a conspiracy, I tell you. In fact, my theory, aliens are trying to gain intelligence on our intellectual development and evolution. And I believe there are powerful people assisting them to do so, not realising the risk they're placing themselves and the entire planet in. They must be stopped. Stopped, I say.
Following these reports of these men in black at various universities, we chose the one institution where reports of essay abduction was the highest, UWS Nepean.
Our crew, using the most sophisticated hidden camera technology, placed a surveillance camera in one of these offices in the hope of catching one of these so-called men in black in the act. The following footage some viewers may find disturbing.
How much more proof is necessary? The university surveillance camera also caught the man leaving. Despite our attempts at getting to the core of this conspiracy, the phenomena of essay abduction remains unsolved. No definite proof that will connect the world's governments to UFO essay abduction has been uncovered. Hopefully we have succeeded in opening your eyes at least.
Against all odds, the search for the truth continues. And the truth is out there. I'm Joe King. Good night.